Okay. Okay. I'm Sue Franklin, living in Fort Davis, Texas, married to James Franklin. I agreed to speak to you in hopes that you would do something about regulations for the oil industry in Texas. We do indeed need something done so other ordinary people like my husband and I, living out here in the middle of nowhere, might not also be driven out of their homes after being made ill by the poisonous SO2 gases released into our air. My husband and I lived in Verhalen, Texas at 204 FM 3334. That site now contains yet two more poisonous gas wells on FM 3334. We intended on retiring, living, and dying in the future on that ranch. The oil industry seemed to have the intention of speeding up the dying process. We were surrounded by seven poisonous gas wells around our ranch. The worst well was called the Red Unit and was less than 1 mile from our home. We were told we would never smell any of the gas, but many were the nights I would wake up choking from the stench in my bedroom of rotten eggs, the SO2 smell. We submitted complaints to the TCEQ in hopes of having them stem the flow of this horrible gas, but our complaints were never addressed. Mind you, we were told the site was inspected and everything was in perfect order during the daylight hours, to be sure. This unit was eventually shut down by the Railroad Commission, but only for lack of signage. When the inspector went to reinspect the unit to lift closure, we were asked to come along, I guess in hopes of us speaking to someone in charge of the unit. The man who was there was only interested in getting his unit back up. When he was asked if he could please speak to him about the damage being caused to our health, he just sneered and said he had no authority other than turning the unit back to operation. The reason we were invited was to alleviate the problems we were having, waking up every morning with severe headaches, and I myself was having breathing problems. I have never had any problem before, but the doctor finally had to put me on a prescription called Montaculos and also gave me an emergency inhaler. My health has never gotten better, and I have been sure it will not repair itself. The same company eventually put yet another well directly across the street from our house, no more than 400 yards away from our home. The noise and constant glare of light made it most intolerable. When the flare was lit, our bedroom was flooded with light, and the flare made an awful roar which could not be ignored. And the flare was lit and burning at least 80% of the time. I was told regulations were that the flare could only be lit during and burning for 9 days. Then the gas was to be reclaimed and set into a pipeline. This never occurred while we lived there. After the media contacted me, I agreed to speak to them and tell my story. I guess I got too noisy for that particular oil company, and they offered to buy us out. We had to sign a waiver stating that we would never speak that company's name again. I have abided by that ruling, but anyone could drive by and see what company it is, as they are required to post signage of ownership and operation. I am truly in sincere hope that the EPA will establish much stricter codes here in Texas to help control this raping of our precious, beautiful land, as well as to stop killing our wildlife. I personally found two hawks lying dead on the ground near the Red Unit, less than a mile from our house, and they were in perfect condition, had not been hit by a vehicle or maimed in any way. I also found one of our owls out there as well, on the road, just dead for no obvious reason. All of our quail disappeared, the deer, as well as rabbits, and even the coyotes cleared out. The entire area was made inhospitable for the wildlife as well as human life to live there. I beg, please take some action on the raping of our United States lands and try to restore the fresh air and beautiful land for our future generations. I thank you so much for this opportunity to tell you our story as to what has happened to us here in Texas. Thank you.
Thank you for that testimony, Ms. Franklin. Are there any questions from the panel? I thank you again, Ms. Franklin.
Thank you.
Next speaker is Elizabeth.